Dear students, today I am going to teach about the topic numbers. It is very important to face all competitive examinations. So listen carefully what I am teaching now. A number is denoted by a group of digits. A number is denoted by a group of digits called numeral. Is called numeral. We have 10 digits, namely 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These are the digits. Now we are going to see the type of numbers. So the type of numbers, very basic. First one, natural number. The natural number denoted by the letter N. Natural number is nothing but counting numbers. So counting numbers are called natural numbers. For example, 10, 20, 256. These are the counting numbers. Thus, the numbers starting with 1, 2, 3, etc. are all natural numbers. Next number, whole number. Whole number denoted by the letter W, capital W. All counting numbers and 0. So 0 will be included. All counting numbers and 0 form the set of whole numbers. Thus, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. are called whole numbers. Next number, integers. Integers normally denoted by the letter capital Z. Set of all integers, all counting numbers, comma, 0 and negatives of counting numbers. Negatives of counting numbers form the set of integers. Thus, the negatives of counting number is nothing but minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. Next to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So these are called the integers. These are called the integers. So some kinds of integers. First one, set of positive integers. The positive integers nothing but starting with 1, 2, 3, etc. These are the positive integers. Next, set of negative integers. Negative integers is nothing but minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. is going. We don't know what is the last value. Similarly, the set of positive integers also we don't know what is the last value. Next, set of all non-negative integers. Non-negative integers, 0 included. So 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. We don't know about the last value. So these are the some kinds of integers. Next number, even numbers. Even numbers is a counting number divisible by 2. A counting number divisible by 2 is called even number. Thus 0, 1, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. These are the even numbers. Next, odd numbers. What is mean by odd numbers? A counting number not divisible by 2, that's all. A counting number not divisible by 2 is called an odd number. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, etc. are all odd numbers. These are the all numbers. So the counting number is very important. So counting number is not divisible by 2. That type of number is called odd numbers. Next number, prime numbers. A counting number is called a prime number if it has exactly two factors, namely itself and 1. That's all. So once again I am telling, a counting number is called a prime number if it has exactly two factors. Two factors, namely itself and 1. For example, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, etc. These are the prime numbers. So for your information, here 2 is the only even prime number. So even prime number is only 1, that number is 2. So remaining number are all odd numbers. So these are the prime numbers. Now how to check the given number will be a prime? So test for a number to be a prime. So now I am talking about the definition of the numbers. So after completing this session, next we go to the problem solving. So test for a number to be a prime. Let P be a given number and let N be the smallest counting number such that n squared greater than or equal to p. Such that this is the condition, n squared greater than or equal to p. Now test whether p is divisible by any of the prime numbers less than or equal to n. Any of the prime number less than or equal to n. If yes, p is not a prime number. Otherwise, p is prime. Okay, are you clear? Understand? Are you clear? So once again, I'm telling, telling the definition, let p be a given number and let n be the smallest counting number such that n squared greater than or equal to p. Now test whether p is divisible by any of the prime number less than or equal to n. Any of the prime number less than or equal to n. If yes, p is not a prime number. Otherwise, p is a prime number. So now, just we see one small example. Test which of the following are prime numbers. So these are the problems. The first one 137, second one 173, third problem 319, fourth one 437, last one 811. So now we are going to check. So which one is prime number? So the next, first I consider the first problem. We know that first problem 137. Problem number 137. Now we are going to check it is prime or not. How to check? So we know that according to the definitions, so let n be the smallest counting number such that n squared greater than or equal to p. So here 137, the perfect square number will be 12 squared. 12 squared, the value of 12 squared is 144. 144 must be greater than 137. So according to the definitions, we take 12 squared greater than 137. Now, therefore, the prime number less than or equal to 12. Now the prime number less than or equal to 12 are, what are the prime numbers so less than 12? 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. These are the prime numbers will be less than 12. So among these factors, any one of the value divisible by 137, no, it is not possible. So this prime number is not divisible by 137. So we can strongly tell 137 is a prime number. Okay, understand? Are you understand? Second problem. Check problem number 3. I can consider the problem number 3, 319. Let us consider the problem 319. Now, we know that 18 squared greater than 319. Okay. 18 squared greater than 319. Okay. So, here 324. 18 squared the value is 324. 324 will greater than 319. Okay. So, now we are going to find the prime number the less than 18. Less than 18. What are the possible prime number? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13 and 17. These are the possible prime number in less than 18. So, out of this prime number, 11 divides 319 completely. So, clear, are you understand now? So out of this prime number, 11 is divisible by 319. Therefore, we strongly told 319 is not a prime number. Okay, are you understand? So this is the checking for given number will be a prime number. Okay. Next problem. Composite number. The natural numbers which are not prime, that type of number is called composite numbers. Okay. A natural number which are not prime are called composite numbers. Okay. Next, co-prime numbers. What is co-prime numbers? Two natural numbers, a and b, small a and small b. Two natural numbers, small a and small b, are said to be co-prime if they are HCF. HCF means highest common factor. Highest common factor is 1. For example, two natural number, we can take 2, 3 and 4, 5, 7, 9, etc. These are the pairs of prime numbers, pairs of natural numbers. In this natural number are all co-prime because the highest common factor of these 2, 3 is 1. Similarly, the highest common factor is 4, 5 is 1. Similarly, the HCF of 7 and 9 is 1. So, this is the definition of co-primes. Now, we are going to see the test of divisibility. The first condition, divisibility by 2. The first one, divisible by 2. So a number is divisible by 2 if its unit digit is any of 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. So if a number if a number is divisible by 2 if its unit digit. So unit digit is any of these value 0 2 4 6 and 8. For example, 1 2 3 4 5 6, it is exactly divisible by 2 because the unit digit will be 6. It's divisible by 2, so entire number will divisible by 2, that's all. Similarly, why 1 2 3 7 is not divisible by 2? Because the unit digit will be 7. 7 is not divisible by 2, so it is not divisible by 2. Next, divisible will be 3. Divisibility by 3. A number is divisible by 3 only when the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. Sum of its digits. All of you understand, sum of its digit is divisible by 3. Okay. For example, I can take one number 6 9 5 4 2 1. So whether this is divisible by 3 or not, how to check this number is divisible by 3 or not? Sum of the digits. Sum of the digit means 6 plus 9 plus 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. This is the sum of the digits. The sum of the digit value become a 27. Sum of the digits is equal to what? Sum of the digit means 6 plus 9 plus 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. So the value will become 27. We know 27 is divisible by 3, so the entire number will be divisible by 3, that's all. This is the condition for the given number divisible by 3. Similarly, consider the next problem, 9 4 8 6 5 3. Again, you check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. So taking the sum of the digits, sum of the digits will become a 35. 35 is not divisible by 3, therefore it is not divisible, the given number which is not divisible by 3, that's all. This is the checking for divisibility by 3. Now next, divisibility by 9. This is also same for divisible by 3. A number is divisible by 9 only when the sum of its digit is divisible by 9. Sum of its digits is divisible by 9. Okay, now for example, 2 4 6 5 9 1. Again, you take the sum of digits. Sum of digits will become 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 5 plus 9 plus 1, it will be a 27. So 27 will divisible by 9, therefore the entire number, it is divisible by 9. If not divisible by 9, the entire number which is not divisible by 9. So you see the next problem, 7 3 4 5 1 9. The sum of digit will be 29. 29 is not divisible by 9, so the entire number will not divisible by 9. This is the divisibility by 9. Next problem, next condition, divisibility by 4. A number is divisible by 4 if the sum of its last two digits is divisible by 4. So very important, the sum of its last two digit is divisible by 4. For example, consider one number 6 8 7 9 3 7 6. Since the last two digit will be 76, 76 will be divisible by 4 because so 1 4 are 4, remainder 3 36 9 9 4 are 36. Therefore the given number, the entire number is divisible by 4. Next problem, 4 9 6 1 3 8. Here 30, the last two digit will be 38. So we know 38 is not divisible by 4. So then we strongly say that the given number is not divisible by 4. Next condition, divisibility by 8. So in this term, the number is divisible by 8 if the number formed by hundreds, tens and units, hundreds, tens and unit digit of the given number is divisible by 8. For example, consider the number 1 6 7 8 9 3 5 2. So now we are going to check whether the given number is divisible by 8 or not. So according to the condition, consider the last three digit. Last three digit means, so you take unit digit, tens digit and 100 place. So these are the three numbers. Now we are going to check this number is divisible by 8 or not. 352. The last number is 352. We told that 352 is exactly divisible by 8. Yeah, because how many 8s are there? So 352 by 8, this is equal to 35. Therefore 4 8s are 32, remainder 3 again 32, 4 8s are 32. So the last 3 digit will be divisible by 8. So the entire number will be divided by 8. That's all. Similarly, the another one, 5 7 6 4 8 4. Now we are going to check it is divisible by 8 or not. So consider the last 3 digit 484. So we strongly say that 484 is not divisible by 8. So the entire number is not divisible by 8. Next, it is very easy, divisible by 10. The number is divisible by 10 only when its unit digit is 0. That's all. Similarly, divisibility by 5, it is also very simple. A number is divisible by 5 only when its unit digit is 0 or 5. It is the only possibility for the given number is divisible by 5. Next condition, divisibility by 11. If the difference between the sum of its digits at odd places and the sum of its digits at even places is either 0 or a number divisibility by 11. So very important. So we can take odd sum of digits at odd places and the sum of its digits at even places, either 0 or a number divisible by 11. A number divisible by 11 means 11, 22, 33, these are the numbers divisible by 11. So now we are going to one small example. Consider the number 29435417. So according to the condition, we can separate the two parts. The first one, sum of its digits at odd places minus sum of its digits at even places. So what are the digits in odd places? The first one, 7 4 7 4 3 9, these are the odd places digits. So 7 plus 4 plus 3 plus 9 minus next even number, even place, the sum of digits at even place. So here 1 5 4 2, adding this value 23, again adding this value 12, 23 minus 12 will be 11. So 11 is divisible by 11. So the condition, according to the condition, the entire number is divisible by 11. That's all. Now we are going to solve the problem based on the definitions. First problem, example, very simple problem. Problem number 9587 minus, we are going to find this number, minus, it is equal to 7429 minus 4358. Now we are going to find what is the value of this symbol. Let us consider this symbol is a question mark. Let us consider the symbol is x. So normally we can consider any value it's not present or finding that value in mathematics. Let us consider that value will become a x. So the given expression can be written as 9587 minus x is equal to 7429 minus 4358. So subtraction of these two numbers, they will become 3071. Therefore 9587 minus x is equal to 3071. Okay, now change the value, transform the value of x in right hand side. So x is equal to next 9587 minus 3071, the value become 6516. So you know the how to solve this type of numbers. It's a very simple one. Now I am going to start with the problem very simple one. Next question, 579 3405 into 9999, that is equal to what? So it is a problem. Now we are going to solve what is the answer, how to solve this problem. So this value 9999, so we can consider this value become 10,000 minus 1 for easiest calculations, because in your competitive examination electronic devices should be prohibited. So without calculator you can solve the given problems, aptitude problems. So how to calculate? We don't know the time, so within a minute you must solve the minimum of two problems, then only you are able to solve all problems. So this is the trick. So here 4 nines are there, so in this term we can write 10,000 minus 1. 10,000 minus 1 become 9,999. So 9,999 we can write 10,000 minus 1. So why we are take this type of transformation? For easiest calculation, that's all. That's why I'm taking. So now we are going to multiply inside. So 5,793,405 into 10,000, so we can add 40, that's all. Next 1 into this value, this value. Next simple subtraction. After subtraction of these two terms we can get the answer. Simple. Okay, are you understand? Next problem, 976 into 237 plus 976 into 763, that is equal to what? Now we are going to find the result of this number. So now applying the distributive property. Applying the distributive property. What is distributive property? The given expression 976 is common for these two terms. So 976 take outside. So what we have remaining? 237. Here 763. So 976 half 237 plus 763. The value of the summation of these two numbers will become a 1000. 1000 into 976, 976,000. That's all. This is the problem. This is using for a simple distributive property. It's a very easiest calculations. Okay. Next problem, 1607 into 1607. You guess what is the answer? You have 30 seconds. You have 30 seconds only. Within 30 seconds you must solve this problem. How to solve this problem? So using the some trick. So here 1607, it's present in two times. So 1607 into 1607 equal to 1607 the whole square. Simply x into x equal to x square, a into a equal to a square, that's all. Here 1607 the whole square. How to write this? So 1607 whole square we don't know, but we know about the formula. 1607 can be written as 1600 plus 7 the whole square. So it is the form of a plus b whole square. So transform the given number into the algebraic expression. A plus b the whole square, the formula, very famous formula, a squared plus b squared plus 2ab. This is the formula for a plus b the whole square. Now you can express, you can use this formula here. So here a equal to 1600, b equal to 7. Using this formula, here a square means 1600 square plus b square 7 square plus 2ab. 2 into 1600 into